Hello, everyone. Welcome back into the Fairbanks Evening News. Mike Schultz with you once again, taking a look at the weather. And you can say adios to 70-degree temperatures. They're going bye-bye for this year. We're looking at temperatures slowly dropping down to around 50 degrees by this weekend. We'll talk more about that in just a little bit. Look at this photograph for tonight. This is a beautiful sunset. This one's sent in by Rosemarie and Jerry Atkinson. And again, you see the colors are very vivid there. Nice photograph. And as always, if you have a photograph to share, by all means, send it to photos at ktvf11.com. I'm getting lots of great photos being sent in, so be patient if I haven't put yours up yet. Here's what's going on as far as the numbers out at the airport. Our high today, 62. Normally, the high is 57. And the normal low is 36. Today's overnight low, lifeline overnight low is 40 degrees. Record high 71 in 1973, but in 1992, temperature dropped down to 12 degrees for the overnight low. Sunrise about 12 hours and 50 minutes, a loss of 6 minutes from yesterday. Once again, an area of low pressure sitting over the southwest part of the state. The counterclockwise flow helping to bring lots of moisture in across the southern half of the state. But again, the Alaska Range blocking out most of it from getting in the interior. We are looking at some showers right now. In fact, we'll zoom in around the area and show you there are some showers around the Fairbanks area, but nothing really strong. And most of them are keeping to the west and down to the south. And what's going on across the rest of the state today? Well, for the most part, cloudy skies around Juneau, sunny to partly cloudy skies in the Ketchikan area. Over south central sections, it's raining from Anchorage right on down to Kodiak Island. You saw it on the satellite and radar. And over the west coast, things look pretty good until you get to Nome. Then there's more rain being reported there. 37 degrees and some low clouds in the Barrow area. Lower 48 weather. Well, again, we're talking about warm temperatures, but not as high as it was yesterday in Seattle because they have showers. 72 degrees there. 81 in San Francisco. How about that? Again, very hot temperatures over the southwest, over the central plains. Temperatures pretty warm too. Denver, 88 degrees. Then cooling off as you move around the Great Lakes. New York at 69 degrees. Miami, thunderstorms and 90 degrees. And as far as our satellite and radar, there's the energy moving up from what was once a Hurricane Odile, and this is going to be a big deal for the folks down there, bringing with it flash floods. In fact, the overall outlook is calling for that tropical moisture to continue moving to the north, flooding places like Tucson, right on into Las Cruces, New Mexico, El Paso, Texas. It'll be bypassing California, unfortunately. And they need the moisture in the worst way because of the drought they're going through. The overall jet stream, once again, showing it to move way to the north, allowing all the warm and humid air to come up from the south over a large portion of the country to the north. It's cooler, as you would expect, over the Great Lakes. Well, back to Alaska for tomorrow in the northern sections. Here's what it looks like. Scattered showers at Barrow and Nome, but mostly sunny skies expected for the Fort Yukon area. High of 60 degrees at Fort Yukon. Here in the interior, mostly sunny skies at Fairbanks, but more clouds expected in the Healy and Delta Junction area, and Delta looking at 61 degrees. Over southeast Alaska, cloudy skies for Juneau, and mainly cloudy skies also around the Ketchikan area, 60 degrees for the high at Ketchikan. Out to the southwest, cloudy skies with showers at Cold Bay and Bethel, with rain likely in the Kodiak region. And over the south central regions, we're looking at more rain, widespread, scattered showers for Anchorage and Homer, and more showers expected for Valdez. Okay, time once again for our kids' weather. And this week we're talking with the kids from Badger Road Elementary School. And tonight, here's a young man with a very interesting picture to share with us.
My name is Jake Dolly, and I go to school at Badger Road Elementary. And this is a picture of my dad flying through the rain and is in his F-16 before he retired after 20 years of serving in the military.
Nice picture, Jacob, and be sure to tell your dad thanks from all of us for his service to our country. Again, thanks to Mount McKinley Bank for sponsoring our Kids Weather Watch. And tomorrow night, another young man will be here with a question for me. All right, here's your forecast for the remainder of the night. A pretty nice evening, just some scattered clouds, 40 degrees, the overnight low. Tomorrow's forecast, which is about what it was like today, mainly partly cloudy to mostly sunny skies with 63 degrees for the high. And the extended forecast, again, temperatures dropping down to the mid-50s to around 50 degrees by Sunday. Maybe some showers in the picture for Saturday and Sunday. And temperatures, like I said, showing that cooling trend heading on down to where the temperature should be this time of year. Maybe even a little cooler next week, but nothing bad on the horizon to talk about. And that's always good news to pass along.